And is recognized for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I want to thank the gentlelady from North Carolina for her leadership on this issue and so many other issues on the Education and Workforce Committee. Mr. Speaker, when so many of our fellow citizens are hurting, when so many of our fellow citizens are looking for work, when so many of our fellow citizens are striving to meet their familial and societal obligations, and all they want is the most basic of all family values, which is a job. And as my friend Tim Scott, my friend and colleague from Charleston, so eloquently put it this morning, the NLRB thinks it's a joke, Mr. Speaker. A joke. They're making jokes about it. Airbus is not just another plane manufacturer. They're the direct competitor to Boeing. Virtually everyone is familiar with the most glaring example of NLRB overreach, which is the complaint they filed against Boeing. And not a single example of job loss has been cited. Not a single worker has lost a single benefit in the state of Washington. Nevertheless, the NLRB sued Boeing, and they seek to have Boeing mothball the facility in North Charleston and displace 1,000 workers and return the work to a union state. That is Exhibit A in NLRB's, activist agenda, and I regret to say this as a former prosecutor who actually values impartiality and fairness, Mr. Speaker. They have become a sycophant of big labor. And while Boeing is Exhibit A, it is by no means, Mr. Speaker, the only evidence of an activist, politically motivated agenda. Currently, union elections, Mr. Speaker, take place on average within 31 days of the filing of an election petition. Additionally, unions are victorious more often than not. But unions want more. So they persuaded the NLRB to propose sweeping changes to the rules and regulations governing the election process, shifting the balance of power even further towards those employees seeking unionization. By promoting rush elections and ruling that elections can take place in as little as 10 days, Mr. Speaker, the NLRB severely limits the opportunity for workers to hear all sides of the issue and make an informed decision. Additionally, employers would only have 7 days to retain legal counsel and decipher the complex labyrinth of federal labor law before presenting their case before an NLRB hearing officer. Education and Workforce Committee Chairman John Klein smartly introduced H.R. 3094, the Workforce Democracy and Fairness Act, to level the playing field. This legislation requires no union election occur in less than 35 days, thus granting all parties the ability to present their arguments and ensuring workers have the ability to reach an informed decision. H.R. 3094 acknowledges that full and complete information is treasured when employees are contemplating how they will vote. Ironically, Mr. Speaker, some unions have already endorsed President Obama's re-election bid, which is well nigh a year off. Clearly, they believe they need the time, the 12 months, to inform their members. But somehow a week is enough for employers to inform their employees of all salient facts before an election. The hypocrisy and blind advocacy towards big labor has to stop, Mr. Speaker. The purpose of the National Labor Relations Board is to enforce the National Labor Relations Act. And the purpose of the National Labor Relations Act is to balance the rights of employers, employees, and the general public. The Act is not calculated to drive up union membership, because they happen to be a loyal constituency of the Democrat Party. Because the NLRB, through its filing of proposed rules and regulations, has lost all pretense of objectivity, Mr. Speaker, in labor issues, fair, even-handed pieces of legislation like Chairman Klein's Workforce Democracy and Fairness Act are necessary. And in conclusion, Mr. Speaker, I encourage my colleagues to help us protect American jobs, to stand up for equal access to justice, to promote a level playing field. I encourage my colleagues to support the rule and support the underlying bill. And with that, I would yield back the balance of my time.
Gentleman yields back his time. Gentleman from Colorado.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'd like to yield 3 minutes to the gentleman.